Heat transfer by convection. It is a heat transfer mechanism where heat flow occurs between solid and a fluid. So let us consider a solid that is hot and it is dissipating heat and there is heat flow vertically up. So how does this come about? If you see the immediate environment of the solid, there are layers of molecules. So you will have the immediate neighborhood becoming hot by diffusion, the molecules become hot by diffusion, and it progressively decreases, and the temperature of the molecules quite far away from the solid will not have that high temperature as the ones close to it. So if you consider the fluid molecules close to the solid, they will be hot. And the fluid molecules away from the solid, they will not be as hot. So the hotter molecules will start traveling up, moving up, because they are less dense, and the colder, heavier molecules will start moving down. So there is a circulation of the fluid naturally, and this is the convection movement, and this is called the natural or the free convection. You can also have forced convection, where you are forcing the molecules to move, carrying the heat away with them by putting a fan here. So let us now see how we obtain the relationship for the heat flow. So this is the hot surface, and I will put a measurement called delta x here. Now delta x is the thickness of the fluid. See, when we considered the solid block, we said delta x was the thickness of the block in conduction, and it was easy for us to measure delta x. But in the case of the fluid, what is the thickness of the fluid? Now that is an uncertain quantity. Now anyway, let us now put down the equation. We know that Q is equal to Ka delta T by delta x. This is the heat flow rate equation. Now everything is known. You know the thermal conductivity, you know the area of cross section across which the heat is flowing, orthogonally delta T, the temperature of the hot surface, the temperature of the external ambient, and delta X is the thickness of the fluid. Now this is an uncertain quantity. So normally what is done, commonly done, is that a lot of experimentation has been done, and then different geometries of solids have been characterized. So a slight modification, a variant of that, is I multiply and divide by a variable x. Now what this x is, let me tell you in a short moment. So delta T by that variable x. Now this is a characteristic x. Now this x by delta x, this is called the Nusselt's number, after the work done by Nusselt on heat flow. This is called the Nusselt's number, and this uppercase x is called the characteristic dimension of the solid. So it could be the length, or it could be the breadth, or it could be the height of the cylinder, or the diameter of the cylinder. So depending upon the way the solid object is positioned and its geometry, characteristic dimensions of the solids have been identified for various solids by experimentation. So we will use that characteristic dimension to arrive at the value of the Nusselt's number. Now let us say you have this Nusselt's number by some means. I will discuss how we calculate the how we determine the Nusselt's number. But let us say we have the Nusselt's number, then we have this relationship Ka Nusselt's number to delta T by characteristic dimension x. The thermal resistance, R thermal, and for convection they use the subscript V. So thermal resistance convection is given by characteristic dimension x by thermal conductivity, area of cross section, Nusselt's number. So this is the important equation for convection that you should remember and use. Remember that there are two variants in convection. One is the free convection, the natural convection, and the forced convection. Forced convection is if you put a fan or a blower and speed up the molecules that are in contact with the solid, that is called forced convection. Free convection, the natural convection, is the natural circulation that is attained by the movement of the molecules due to the density movement. When a portion of the molecules become hotter than the other set of molecules which are far removed from the surface, which are colder. So it should be noted that the Nusselt's number is not the same for free convection and forced convection. Nusselt's number is different for free convection and different for forced convection. How do we go about calculating Nusselt's number? I will just now shortly discuss. Now let us see how we determine the Nusselt's number for various solids, various geometries. This is by a series of empirical relationship. Now to determine the Nusselt's number, I said that the Nusselt's number is different for free convection and for forced convection. So for free convection, we have the relationship of another number. This is called the Rayleigh number. Okay, where each of these are, this is the Rayleigh number. G is the acceleration due to gravity, 9.81 meter square per second. Beta is the coefficient of thermal expansion of the fluid. So this is given in science tables, and for air I will tell you it is 1/330. X is the characteristic dimension, which I will have to discuss. Delta is the thermal diffusivity. Again, this is a property of the fluid which is given in science tables, and for air it is 2.6 10 to the power of minus 5 meter square per second. Nu is kinematic viscosity, and again it is given in science tables, not to worry. And for air I'm writing it down, 1.8 in 10 to the power of minus 5 meter square per second, because we most of our experiments will have the air as the fluid medium. So we apply these values here. X characteristic dimension, I will tell you how to get that. Delta T is the temperature difference. You will get a Rayleigh number. And Nusselt's numbers can be expressed in terms of the Rayleigh number for free convection. I will tell you how to express the Nusselt's number in terms of the Rayleigh number. Now for the forced convection part, another number called the Reynolds number is used, U into X by nu, where R is the Reynolds number, U is the mean velocity of the forced fluid. See, if you are using a fan, blower, some such device, then the airflow, what is the mean velocity of the airflow that you are forcing is what is needed, and that is U. You can get that value. X again is the characteristic dimension, I will discuss that, and nu is the kinematic viscosity, just like as I have indicated here. So now consider the free convection for standard solids, and first important one is horizontal flat plate. So many of the heat sinks are flat plates. Let's say horizontal flat plate. It can be it can be rectangular, or it can be circular. So if it is rectangular, it has two important dimensions, A and B, and it is placed flat. The fluid flow is up like that. And if it is circular, you have a dimension D, diameter, and the fluid flow is like that. So X, the characteristic dimension for the rectangular flat plate, is A plus B by 2, and X is D, that is the diameter for a circular flat plate. Now, if the flow is laminar, that you can find out from the Rayleigh number. If it is lying between 10 to the power of 2 and 10 to the power of 5, then the Nusselt's number is given by this empirical relationship 0.54 to Rayleigh number to the power of 0.25. For turbulent flow, where the Rayleigh number turns out to be greater than 10 to the power of 5, Nusselt's number is given by 0.14 Rayleigh number to the power of 0.33. So this way you can find out the Nusselt's number for horizontal flat plate. Likewise, for the vertical flat plate also you can find out based on the experimental results and the empirical relationships. You have the vertical plate A and B, and you have the fluid flow up in this fashion. And likewise, for a circular vertical plate of diameter D, you have fluid flow up, x is equal to b, only the vertical dimension is taken, and x is equal to d in the case of the circular. So for the laminar flow, which is between 10 power 4 and 10 power 9, Nusselt's number is given by 0.56, a Rayleigh number to the power of 0.25. For turbulent flow, which is between these limits, Nusselt's number is given by 0.28, the Rayleigh number to the power of 0.4. So in this way you can obtain the Nusselt's number for horizontal and vertical flat plate. Higher the Nusselt's number, lower will be the thermal resistance and better it is for heat conduction, for removal of the heat. Another commonly used solid is a solid cylinder. So consider a horizontal solid cylinder in this fashion, which has a length of L, diameter D, like this as shown, and you will have the fluid flow moving up like this. So for this, the X is D, the characteristic dimension is D. For laminar flow, where the Rayleigh number is between 10 to the power of 4 and 10 to the power of 9, Nusselt's number is given by 0.47 Rayleigh number to the power of 0.25. And for turbulent flow, where the Rayleigh number is greater than 10 to the power of 9, Nusselt's number is given by 0.1 Rayleigh number to the power of 0.33. Now the same cylinder, you can keep it vertical solid cylinder, and you can get slightly different Nusselt's number characteristics. You have the length L and the diameter D. The flow is up and X is the characteristic dimension is L in this case. And the laminar flow is Nusselt's number is given by 0.56 Rayleigh number to the power of 0.25. And for turbulent flow, the Nusselt's number is given by 0.2 Rayleigh number to the power of 0.4. Another commonly used solid configuration is the parallel flat plates. So the parallel flat plates can be placed in this fashion, where plate 1 could be at temperature T and the other plate could be at a slightly different temperature T plus delta T, and they could be separated with the distance D, and there could be turbulent flow within. Or the parallel plate could be placed at an angle to the horizontal angle theta, and then you have T and T plus delta T for the two plate temperatures separated by a distance D, and you can have turbulent flow within like this. So here the characteristic dimension is D, and characteristic dimension is D in both the cases as long as the theta is less than 50 degrees. Now only turbulent flow is found out for this. Rayleigh number greater than 10 to the power of 5, the Nusselt's number is 0.062 Rayleigh number to the power of 0.33. So in this way, most of the geometries fall in this fashion. If it is not, if you cannot fit a standard geometry for a particular experiment, for a particular solid, then it is better to experimentally find out what is the Nusselt's number or what is the thermal resistance for that particular solid. For the case of forced convection, let us consider two geometries for the solid. One is a flat plate and the other is a cylinder. And if we put a fan, consider this flat plate, and if you put a fan in this fashion where there is a flow of the fluid along the length of the flat plate, which is having a dimension A like this as shown, then the characteristic dimension is A. Now for such a configuration, for laminar flow, Reynolds number less than 5 into 10 to the power of 5, the Nusselt's number is given by 0.664, Reynolds number to the power of 0.5, kinematic viscosity by diffusivity of the fluid to raise to the power of 0.33. For turbulent flow where the Reynolds number is greater than 5 into 10 to the power of 5, Nusselt number is given 0.37, Reynolds number to the power of 8, and viscosity by diffusivity raised to the power of 0.33. The other solid configuration is a cylindrical configuration kept vertical like this with a diameter of D, and I have the fan positioned in this fashion and you have the fluid flow shown like that. X for this is given as D. Now for this also the laminar flow where the Reynolds number is between 0.1 and 1000, Nusselt's number is given in this fashion, and for turbulent flow where Reynolds number is from 1000 to 5 into 10 to the power of 5, you have Nusselt's number given like this. So these are the Nusselt's number values that you have to use for the various solid geometries in the thermal resistance equation, that is thermal resistance given by X, characteristic dimension by thermal conductivity K, A, Nusselt's number, X by K, A, N. Now that is how you go about calculating the thermal resistance for convection.